Hi friends, let us see one more variation in a problem of how to apply window technique to type 2 problem. In type 2 problem, you are given HD of e raised to j omega. So let's say this to be type, okay. HD of e raised to j omega is given as 1 to me from, let's say, 2 less than equal to mod omega less than equal to pi and 0 otherwise. So they are specified like this. I have been given as HD of e raised to j omega as equal to 1 from 2 to pi, and they are given mod pi and 0 otherwise. Okay. Now, according to the normal type 1 problems, okay, in type 1 problems, we will receive HD of e raised to j omega as 1 e raised to some factor, let's say alpha omega. That's it. Always, HD of e raised to j omega in type 1 problems will be 1 e raised to minus j alpha omega. In type 2, we need to bring our given HD of e raised to j omega in this form. So how to find this alpha? Now, to find the alpha, we need m, okay, because alpha is given as m minus 1 by 2, okay. This is a formula for alpha. Alpha is given as m minus 1 by 2. So m should be specified in the problem. Here in the current problem, m is specified as 7. So my alpha will be 7 minus 1 by 2, which will be equal to 3, because it will be 6 by 2, that will be 3. Now, very important, alpha m minus 1 by 2 will only be valid if your m is an odd integer. If it is an even integer, this formula will result into a fractional answer, which is not valid. So do not or always keep your m to be odd if you wanted to use this alpha as your function. Alpha is equal to m minus 1 by 2. Now we got this as 3. Okay. So my nu, so let me write this as nu h d of e raised to j omega will be equal to 1 e raised to minus j. What is my alpha? 3 omega from 2 less than equal to mod omega less than equal to pi and 0 otherwise. Okay, this is type 2 problem in which I need to add one more step to get alpha. Okay, in type 1 problem, they will give me alpha. In the form of alpha, I will receive the input data, but in type 2 problems, I will not receive alpha, but I will get m. From m, I can easily derive alpha using this formula, and I can rearrange the terms to get the required input. So this is what my required input is. Now step 1 is to plot the given data. So let us plot the given data. So let us say that for the solution, step 1 is to plot the given data. Okay, let us plot it. To plot it, I will use a omega minus omega. Maximum limit on omega is minus pi, and the minimum limit, sorry, two extreme limits are minus pi to plus pi, and here it is, let's say 0. Okay, now what they say is that mod of omega is less than equal to is greater than equal to 2 and is less than equal to pi. If I open this modulus, then I will see omega less than equal to plus minus 2 less than equal to plus minus pi. Okay, so omega from plus 2 to plus pi and omega from minus 2 to minus pi. So there are two further limits that I got. One is minus 2 and one is plus 2. Okay, now it says that mod of h d of e raised to j omega is 1 when my function when the value of omega is between plus minus 2 to plus minus pi. So from plus 2 to plus pi the value is 1. Okay, and from minus 2 to minus pi the value is 1 again. So here it is 1 and here also it is 1 and up to pi. Okay, so this is how it looks like. So it does not allow the frequency till 2 radians per second, but it allows the frequency after 2 to pi. Okay, so it does not allow any frequency to pass in this region. This becomes my stop band, and then there are two pass bands. This is my pass band and this is also my pass band. Okay, now let us say that how many regions we have. Again, we have three regions: region 1, region 2, region 3. Region 1 is from minus pi to minus 2, region 2 is from minus 2 to plus 2, and region 3 is from 2 to pi. So let us integrate and let us find the next step, that is a step 2. So step 2 is apply inverse discrete Fourier transform, and I will get h of n, which is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi integral from minus pi to pi, okay, h d of e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n d omega. Okay, now let us directly write the integral. The integral will have the value as 1. There will be this function will exist in between minus 2 to minus pi, or I can say from minus pi to minus 2, because I am coming from minus pi going towards plus pi. So minus pi to 2 the function exists, minus 2 to 2 it is 0, and 2 to pi again it exists. So now two regions exist and one region goes 0. So the integral will shrink to two sub regions, one going from minus pi to minus 2, and h d of e raised to j omega is 1 e raised to minus j 3 omega e raised to j omega n, plus integral goes from plus 2 to pi. From minus 2 to plus 2 the value is 0, so I am not writing it over there. 1 e raised to minus j 3 omega e raised to j omega n d omega. Now so now I will write 1 upon 2 pi, now that this whole thing is inside 1 upon 2 pi. Now, let us do the integration. The integration will, this two bases are same, so I can add the indexes and do the integration directly. So I will get e raised to j n minus 3 omega divided by n minus 3 into j plus e raised to the limit goes from minus pi to minus 2, then here it is e raised to j n minus 3 omega divided by j n minus 3, here the limit goes from 2 to pi. Okay, so now 1 upon 2 pi, put in the upper limit. Putting the upper limit will give me e raised to minus 2, okay, j n minus 3 minus, putting pi value, e raised to minus pi j n minus 3 divided by j n minus 3. Now this is the end of first integral. Then we have addition sign. And then we will perform the second upper limit e raised to pi n minus 3, we have j, okay, minus e raised to j 2 n minus 3 by j n minus 3. Okay, so this is what the integral solution is. What we will do is, we see that the bases are the same, so I can totally add the numerator and we will rearrange the terms, because we see here this is with respect to pi and this is in with respect to pi, this is in terms of 2 and this is also in terms of 2. So all the indexes in terms of 2 will be brought together, all with respect to pi will be brought together. Because the bases are same, I can pull it out together. Okay. So now, from rearrangement I will get h of n as 1 upon 2 pi, rearrangement states e raised to, let's say we will bring the pi terms ahead, keeping the 2 term later, or you can keep 2 terms first and then we will keep the pi term. So let us bring 2 terms together. So it becomes minus 2 j n minus 3 minus e raised to 2 j n minus 3 divided by j n minus 3, then I will put plus over here without changing the sign. I will bring, because I have kept plus in forward, so I will put e raised to j e raised to plus pi n minus 3 and with a j minus e raised to minus j pi n minus 3 upon j n minus 3. Fine. Now again we will recall that sin theta is equal to e raised to j theta minus e raised to minus j theta upon 2j. Now to bring it in this form, this term is exactly what this form is with this 2 if I absorb inside, but this term is not in that form. So what I can do, I can take minus sign common and then I can write it as minus sin theta. Really doesn't matter, in minus sin theta this term becomes minus, this term becomes plus. So here the similar thing is happening. So what I will do is, I will write h of n as 1 upon pi n minus 3, I brought together, because 2 and j I will be utilizing with this term, 2 and j I will be utilizing with this term, and this term becomes, let us take the first term as sin n minus 3 pi minus sin n minus 3 into 2. Okay, so that is a second term. So I got this as first term and this as a second term. Okay, now what further changes we can make? Okay, I can do this much. So that is what my h of n stands for. Okay, so this is my h of n, and after step 2 we get h of n, which is what? This is always infinite. So the length of the sequence will be infinite. To make it finite, I need to perform step 3 on after step 2. That is, we will go for step 3. In step 3, I am going to obtain h dash of n, which is equal to h of n into w of n. Now we need to think or check which w of n is been given or in the problem. What is the windowing function given to us? And the function over here is Hamming. That is, we need to use, we have given that use Hamming window. This has been specified in the problem. Okay, you need to specify in the problem. Now when this happens, we need to write the Hamming window function, which is 0.52, 0.54 plus 0.46 cos 2 pi n upon m minus 1. For 0 less than equal to n less than equal to m minus 1. Now, in the problem, they have given me that m is equal to 7. Right? So, substituting the value of m, I get WH of n equals to 0.54 plus 0.46 cos 2 pi n upon 6 from 0 less than equal to n less than equal to 6, because it is m minus 1 I am going about. So this is 0 to 6. Agreed? So that is my window function. Now, how to go about and how to finish the problem? To finish the problem, we will make a table, okay? And the table will be having the values of n as the first section. Then I will write my HD of n, which is nothing but 1 upon, again, pi n minus 3. Then we have sine n minus 3 into pi minus sine n minus 3 into 2, that is we have just found. And then I will be using my window function W of n. I will not write the whole function now because it is above. And then I will finally get h dash of n, which is nothing but h of n into W of n. So n will take the value from 0 to 6. So I will write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, and let's put the value n is equal to 0 in the whole function. When I put n is equal to 0 in this whole function, the value comes for this as 0.0296. Similarly, when you put n is equal to 0 in this function, the value comes as 1. Okay? Then I put n is equal to 1 over here, it will be 0.12. And when I put n is equal to 1 in this function, it comes as 0.77. Then for n is equal to 2, the value for this comes as minus 0.289. And over here, n comes value 2, we get 0.31. And so on and so forth, you have to solve. How we will solve this? Put n is equal to 0, you get 1 upon pi n 0 minus 3 will give me minus 3 pi. Then you will get sine minus 3 pi minus sine 3 to the 6. So minus 6, that minus will come out and becomes plus. Here it will be minus again. And then when you will solve this, the whole term, you will get some value over here which will get divided. A very point of caution, whenever you are solving this OR window for various values of n, always keep your calculus in radians. Do not keep your calculus in degree and solve these problems. You will start getting wrong answers. So always keep the values in always keep your calculus in radians rather than degrees and solve this function. Now when you multiply this, this becomes 0.0296, this becomes 0.0924, then this value will be minus 0.089 59, and so on so forth for the 6 values here. In all 7, because I started from 0 to 6, it is for this 7 values. So this is how we will get a finite response. Now this h dash of n will be finally a finite with 6, no, 7 numbers.